is a valid response to that violence perpetrated.
The first one, I must tell you, Steve, I'm a skinhead myself. I got not beaten up by skinheads, only it was all kinds of different Nazis, and it was after a wonderful Concerto Grosso of the Totenhosen in Berlin, where me and my friends got really very hardly beaten up. And also another girl, I met her, she got beaten up a couple of years ago by punks in the late 70s. And when I make a comparison between the music I heard from skinhead bands, for example, in 87 in New York, I went to this club Pyramid where lots of them were playing. I could feel the same excitement and the same community feeling amongst them than we used to feel around 77 when we went to punk concerts.
But for people who are particularly on the receiving end of violence from neo-fascists, do you think it is a valid response to be violent?
Oh, God, no. Of course, to be violent is the most horrible and most sinful thing we can do to each other. But we don't function as a human family at all. We are messing up not only ourselves through our racism and fascism, but also racism against our environment and fascism against everything. So basically, it's the biggest problem, and I don't know how to solve it. I was writing anti-Nazi songs for many years, but my record company never allowed me to put it on a record because it would not be commercial enough. So I did it in concerts, and I keep on doing it live on stage.
Okay, I'd like to move on to Campina. Yeah.
I know. Understand absolutely if they fight back. If you get provoked 10 times 20.
Defence organisation in London.
It's an organisation that tackles issues of racial harassment and crucial. You are the problems!
Vigilantes, be responsible for protecting black people.
In fighting back against racism and fascism,
reply to that. He's.
I agree. And if I talk about fighting, I don't only mean.
I'd like to bring in ADL. You were actually brought up with the gypsies in Sweden, weren't you? Tell me about that experience and what were they like?
I mean, to me, gypsies are as good as anybody else in the world, you know what I'm saying? Because. I mean, the problem we have with gypsies in the...
Economically deprived, because they are members and they enjoy all the rights they steal.
And they all of them. Well,
carry on. What do you want to say?
I'm not Matty. That's Matty.
Sorry.
No, my apologies. Right.
But do you know that every gypsy...
Well, someone like you, the stereotypes that you perpetuate, if someone's nicked with...
...has phoned in. Wait 1 second, please. We have someone on the phone. What's your name and where are you from, please? Hello?
Yeah, hello, Steve. It's Darren. I'm phoning from Highbury.
Hi, what's your point?
Yes, I just phoned up. I was just listening to a debate I saw with the gypsies and whatever. And
just leads me to thank the studio audience. Thank you. Thanks to our guests, Nina Hagen, Jean-Paul Gaultier, ADL from Stofunkers, Campino, and Stefan from Boz Uncles. Okay, I'm going to leave you with Sting, in fact, with a famous anti-fascist poem. Good night.